In this video, we're going to talk about the first pillar of calculus. This is the big idea that all of calculus is based on. Close is good enough. You know, some people might say successive approximations. I prefer close is good enough. See, the difference between calculus and algebra is that in algebra you had problems like solve x squared plus x equals 12, which you could rewrite as x squared plus x minus 12 equals 0. And, well, you have a formula. You plug into the quadratic formula minus b plus or minus the square root of b squared minus 4ac over 2a, and you crank it out and you get a number, 3 or minus 4, boom, that's the answer, it's exact. You could also have done it by factoring, or you could have done it by guessing and plugging in, and you see, hey, it works, and you're done. You get exact answers. Calculus, you've got problems where it's hard to envision an exact answer. Calculus, you have problems like, here's your position as a function of time. How fast are you moving at time 1? Okay, well, if it were a straight line, you'd know what to do. But it's not a straight line. It's curving. How do you handle the curves? Or, here's a graph of the rate at which blood is flowing through a particular valve as a function of time, from time 10 to time 40. What's the total amount of blood that flows past the valve in that time? Okay, how do you do that? You know, if it were a constant flow rate, you'd say flow rate times time. Easy. But it's varying all the time. So how do you handle stuff like that? And the answer is you don't try to get an exact answer right away. You try to get an approximate answer. And then you find a way to make the answer better. And you make it better and better and better until you have enough accuracy. Now maybe, you know, 3 decimal points is good enough, and when you get there, you stop. Maybe you want the exact answer, and if you want the exact answer, you have to use a limit. So this recipe, do approximations, make them better, take a limit, is the cornerstone of calculus. Close is good enough for most purposes. Close enough is good enough. Maybe you need a limit. Okay, so let's look at our two problems that way. The usual thing you do is if you have something that's changing at a variable rate, you break it up into little time steps. Instead of looking at the position as a function of time for all times, we're just going to look at time 1, time 0.9, time 0.8, time 1.1, time 1.2, time 1.3. And instead of having this curve, we're going to approximate it with a succession of straight lines. Now, can you tell how fast a straight line is changing? Sure. You figure out how much it went up, divide by how far it went across. That's the slope. That's the rate of change. Now, is the slope of this little line here the same as the speed at exactly t equals 1 second? No. So if you want more accuracy, you break it up finer. And you look at this line. Okay. Now, there are lots of formulas involved. We're not going to get into that today. But the basic idea is the smaller you chunk up your time, the smaller your time step, the more accuracy that you get. Unfortunately, the smaller your time step, usually the more work you have to do. So there's a trade-off. But we're always going to be taking things that are curving. We don't know how to deal with curves. We only know how to deal with straight lines. Break them up into little pieces. Use the straight lines as approximations and deal with that. What about the other problem, the flow rate? Well, we break the interval from 10 seconds to 40 seconds into intervals. Let's say 5-second intervals. And then we say, here's the rate at which you're flowing at time 10. And we'll just pretend that you kept that constant for 5 seconds. And then we'll pretend that you were at another constant rate for the next 5 seconds. And pretend that you were at another constant rate for the next 5 seconds. If it's a constant rate, you know how much blood went. The flow rate times 5 seconds. which happens to be the area of this rectangle. That gives us an approximation to the area under the curve. It's not a very good approximation, but it's an approximation. We take the next 5 seconds, the next 5 seconds, the next 5 seconds, the next 5 seconds, and the next 5 seconds. Add up the areas of those boxes, you got an approximation to the area of the curve. If you want a better approximation, don't break it up every 5 seconds, break it up every second, or every tenth of a second, or every hundredth of a second. The finer you chop things up, the more accurate you're going to get, and the more things you're going to have to add. You get accuracy, and the price is you have to do more work. And that's the game.